Good morning, everybody. This is Ryan Gilkerson, lead creative at Company 119, and this is The Coffee Cup. We're glad you could join us today, where today we're going to take a look at marketing to teenagers. The reason we're doing that is because I'm going to have the privilege this morning of going to Chagrin Falls High School to talk to their marketing class about social media and business. And I thought, what better way to celebrate that occasion than to talk a little bit about how you can sell products and services to kids where they take that information the best, right, on social media and online platforms. So if my virtual assistant, John, could bring up our article today. Virtual assistant, John, bring up the article. There it is. 8 keys to connecting with teens on social media. This is from Business to Community. This is a really cool article. I like a lot of things they say. We're going to dive right into it. First tip that they give is know where to look. Listen, social media is very segmented. Facebook is the most popular social media platform by far. 71% of all people who have a social media account have a Facebook account, even if they have other platforms. So it's kind of standard that everybody's going to have a social media, but they use it in very different ways. Teens don't go on social media to look at products and brands the way adults do. Teens also don't hop on Facebook to get reviews the way adults do. So Facebook isn't the best way to market a product or a service to teens. They really just go on there to see how corny their parents are, that type of stuff. Nothing like marketing. So you've got to go where they are. They're on Snapchat. Teens are on Snapchat more than anything else because it gives them that layer of privacy that they're looking for. And it also, they go online to talk to their friends. You know what I mean? They're there to hang out. And Snapchat is the most social way to hang out for social media for teenagers. So go where they are. Use personalized and short content. At Digital Summit last week, I heard a stat. I shared it on the Coffee Cup last week, but it blew my mind. The average attention span of a U.S. consumer, and this includes teens, is 8 seconds. The average attention span of a goldfish, 9 seconds. Think about that for a second. So we've made fun of goldfish for a long time about how they just swim in circles and don't know where they're going. That's the way we are online when you're talking about what we're paying attention to. So you've got to make something short and sweet and to the point if you're going to connect with teens. Stay aware of new platforms and features. This one is where a lot of people get lost when they're marketing with teens. When you go into your Instagram story now, there's all sorts of different GIFs you can pull up. You can add music, you can add animation, you can add polls. All these new things pop up. And on Snapchat, it's even crazier. There's always new filters, new things to do that are fun. It's not just about finding those things to enhance your messages. It's also finding new platforms. Musical.ly, Periscope, these are things that got really hot for teens, Musical.ly especially. Kids did Musical.ly videos like crazy for a while. So if you manage to hit that at the right time, you would add a great surge for your business on their platforms where other people might have missed out. Right now, Instagram stories are the place to be. You can swipe up to go right to your website to purchase something directly. So if you take advantage of those platforms, you're going to do well with the teens. Make content that's highly shareable. Teens created going viral. That's where it came from. Teens and college kids make things go viral. So if you make something that's catchy, funny, eye-opening, tugs the heartstrings, whatever it is, if you can make something that really makes people feel like they're compelled to share it, that's going to be great for your branding. And once one teen shares it, a million teens share it. They love to share things with each other. You have to be patient and be flexible. Teenagers are a highly volatile demographic. That's one of the reasons why marketers have such a tough time marketing to kids. They move all the time. By the time you find out what social platform they're really into, somebody has found a new one and they're off of that already. So you want to be careful. You don't want to go too heavy with your budget into one particular stream without being ready to abort that stream and go to the next one when that next trend hits and that next crest happens with the marketing trends. Number 6, don't sell. Kids smell BS faster than any other demographic. So if a kid feels like you're trying to sell to them online, they're going to turn you away. They don't want to be sold. They want to feel included. They want to feel like they're part of your brand. They want to feel like they're doing the cool thing. But don't you dare try to sell them something online, because they came from a generation of adults that told them how horrible telemarketing was and how horrible the phone calls were. To them, social media is their telephone. So they don't want a bunch of spam calls trying to get them to buy something online. Just hang out. Chill, bro. You know, be chill. Don't go on there crazy trying to sell people stuff. Number 7, be authentic. My man Eric Thomas was at Digital Summit doing a whole session on being authentic. Don't try too hard. A lot of times people try too hard to be cool and hip and funny with kids, and they miss the point completely when they're trying to market to teenagers. Don't be something you're not. Be who you are. If you're nerdy, if you're an older demographic and you're trying to reach the kids, just know who you are and don't try to confuse your message. Stay true to yourself. And then engage with them. Kids love to give their opinion, feel included, and feel like they're part of something. I just saw where McDonald's is on Snapchat right now, actually hiring from Snapchat. They have an augmented reality filter where you go on and you make a 30-second video about why you want to work at McDonald's, and it puts the hat and the shirt on your body with your face and makes it look like you're wearing the uniform already, and then you make a little video about why you want to work for McDonald's. That makes kids feel so included. They want to be a part of that. They think it's fun. They enjoy that. And the more likely they are to engage with your content and feel included, the more likely they are to have loyalty to your brand and want to respond to your brand, whether it's to get a job or whether it's to buy all your stuff. So, in a conclusion, just be true. Don't try too hard. And connect with kids where they hang out online. So I hope you learn more about marketing to teenagers before you finish your first cup of coffee. I'm going to go see the kids at Chagrin Falls and talk to them about social media. And we might just have some special footage of that tomorrow for you. In the meantime, I hope you have a great day today.